Perhaps I remember you, Scott. Yes, he's here. Of course you may, just a minute. Chuck Scott would like to speak to you, sir.
Fine.
He's on the phone.
Oh.
You said if I ever needed you, I could call. Well, I need you now. Yes. Happened again. Yes. Yes. I'll be there as soon as I can. Thanks.
Take it easy, Chuck. Let's try and start with the beginning.
Can I see Mr. Roman?
What do you want to see him about?
Well, I'd like to give him something that belongs to him.
Where are you going?
Can I see Mr. Roman?
What do you want to see him about?
I'd like to give him something that belongs to him.
Come inside.
What was it you just said at the door?
I said I wanted to see Mr. Roman.
What for?
Well, I've got something for him.
Could mean a lot of things. Where has he gone?
You're not Mr. Roman.
How do you know?
You just don't fit.
Is it all right, Mr. Gino?
I guess it's all right. But I take him in myself.
You.
That's him.
What can I do for you, Jack?
Are you Mr. Roman?
That's right.
What you'd like to have is back. Got your name in it.
Where'd you find it?
I don't remember the name of the street. It was in front of a restaurant.
How much was in it?
$81. I spent $1.50 for breakfast. It was $79.50.
How do you like that for an honest guy?
I don't. Silly law-abiding jerk.
How do you like that? He comes all the way out here just because he found it. You know, you ought to get a medal. Tino, go buy him a medal.
Thanks. I got a medal.
GI, huh?
Yes, I was in the Navy.
I like him. I want to do something for him.
Give him a sawbuck.
That's the trouble with you, Gino. You have no appreciation for honesty. Can you drive a car?
Yes, sir.
And you got a job. What do you need two chauffeurs for?
Fire at Cleveland.
All right.
No, wait a minute. I don't want to take another fellow's job.
Now take it easy, Jack.
The name's Scott. Chuck Scott.
Okay, Scotty.
Hello, Fats. Fats, what do you do besides talking the telephone all the time and trying to reach you for 45 minutes?
Now, never mind that. How about Johnson? Did you contact him yet? Or what's his stall this time? I'll have him at my house for dinner Wednesday night. No, not Thursday. Wednesday.
Yes? Right. Be right there. Thanks, John. Oh, Job. Like in the Bible? Kings, Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, Job. Fine, I won't forget it. Fine.
Johnson, how do you like our little house?
Oh, it's charming. However, I never thought I'd enjoy the pleasure of having dinner here.
You know, Mr. Johnson had the idea I didn't like him. Just because he took away some of my business.
I guess he doesn't know you too well.
I must say there aren't many men would have taken it the way your husband has, Mrs. Roman.
Live and let live.
That's my motto. Isn't that so, Gino?
Oh, the world is big enough for all of us. You too, Mr. Johnson.
Well, thank you, Gino. Now, I have a very interesting house, too, in Havana. I'd be very pleased if you'd all come and visit me sometime. You've been in Havana, haven't you, Mrs. Roman?
No, I've never been there.
No, Mrs. Roman doesn't travel very much.
Oh, I'm sorry. Doctor's orders?
No, mine.
If you'll excuse me, I'll let you go on with your business. Oh, good night, Mr. Johnson.
Good night, Miss Roman.
It was nice meeting you.
Thank you.
She's lovely, isn't she?
Oh, she's beautiful.
How about a little brandy?
Well, I don't mind if I do.
Take it easy, Chuck. Now let's try and start with the beginning.
There doesn't seem to be any beginning. All I can remember is the end of it.
Sit down, Chuck.
The girl that you met here in Miami. That's real. The girl that drove to the beach. The one that wanted to know what's out there straight ahead. That girl.
Yes. But that's all I remember. What she said.
But the beach. You said you remember the beach.
Yeah, the beach.
$1,000 to me to get to Havana.
$1,000?
Yes.
Steamship tickets only about 30.
I could never make it alone.
Why not?
Have you ever been afraid? Really afraid?
What do you want me to do?
I want you to take me to Havana.
But why me?
I think I can trust you. When can we go?
How soon can you leave?
Now, right this minute.
That's a pretty long swim. I'll check the sailings tomorrow. Think I better take you home now?
26 at 11 o'clock tonight.
Scotty.
Yes, sir?
Mrs. Roman goes for a drive almost every day, doesn't she?
Yes, sir.
Where does she go?
Nowhere in particular.
You mean nowhere?
Just along the beach.
I want to go there, Scotty.
Now?
Now.
I wouldn't know.
What do you see out there, Scotty?
Sky, water.
Must have a special meaning for her. What does it mean to you?
I don't know. I'm not a psychiatrist.
You don't have to be to figure this out. Right, Gino?
Pat says she was contemplating a voyage.
She ever say anything to you about it?
Why would she tell me?
You've got the kind of face women like to talk to.
Thank you.
Doctor.
Look at this outfit. Where'd I get this uniform? In the room I woke up in. How'd I get in that house?
Why do you keep looking at the clock?
I don't know, Doc. I keep feeling something I've got to do.
Don't let that worry you. That's symptomatic and shock. But you did remember to call me. You did remember to come. You're pretty well out of it, Jack.
Yes, but I keep feeling that
I know. Technically, this would be identified in a case such as yours as an anxiety neurosis. That sounds terrible, doesn't it? But it's not, Chuck. Believe me, it's not. You understand?
Yes, sir. I still keep feeling that I'm...
Tell Scotty to bring the car in.
Scotty's gone.
Gone?
Going to cost you $125 for a new uniform.
You don't want to go for that ride?
Thanks, no.
Thank you.
confident answer. Might be Scotty.
It couldn't be Scotty. How could it be Scotty? Gino said
maybe
that...
he quit. Maybe he didn't. Yes. Who wants to talk to you? Bassett. Yeah, I wanted to see you. Talk to you about your place. Yeah, I'll be right over. Wait for me. No, alone. Johnson was an obstinate man. I don't like obstinacy.
Why don't you let me have them picked up? How far can we get in that uniform? We can grab them in a minute.
Chuck, I've got to make a phone call. I'll be back in a minute.
Are you listening? Why don't you let me have him picked up?
What I want to know, I can't ask him in the police station.
Oh. What do you think would be the why? Maybe don't get mad, but they're coming from nothing. What I can't get is the guy running out.
Maybe he didn't.
Look, Doc Davis.
Hello? I'm still at the Florida Club. Yes, sir. Oh? Well, I'll be back about a half hour. Bye.
You want to
talk? Oh, hello, Roman.
Hello, Doc.
Hi, Anthony.
How's the name?
Fine.
Commander, huh?
Look at all the spinning.
Done all right for yourself.
Not bad. How's Mrs. Roman?
Fine, thanks. Haven't seen you since you joined.
Yes, it has been some time.
Oh, won't you sit down and join us?
No, thank you. I have a friend waiting for me in the bar.
Still waiting for me. Nice seeing you. Remember me to your wife.
Jubilee, that's 15 minutes ago. If they're on at Jubilee, that's 15 minutes ago. But I don't think they're on at Jubilee. And I think why did they go now? I don't think they're on at Jubilee.
I'm mistaken. Yeah, here it is. Crystal. Great. 42, 11:30.
I'll sit down in the pier to relieve. Bad break. Only two ships leaving tonight. I think you're stupid.